الله عليه وسلم عن أسامة بن زيد رضي الله عنه قال قلت يا رسول الله لم أراك تصوم شهرا من الشهور ما تصوم من شعبان قال ذاك شهر يغفل الناس عنه بين رجب ورمضان وهو شهر يرفع الأعمال ترفه فيه الأعمال إلى رب العالمين وأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم أخرج النسائي في السنن أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. Respected brothers, sisters, ICI community members, our brothers and sisters and families out there, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has provided us with many blessings in our life. And we are thankful to the Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal for the blessings that He has given us. As we are going through these difficult moments in our time, and the situation is prolonging, and we are looking for the mercy of and waiting for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's try to focus on the things that are in our capacity and we can do in our daily basis to focus ourselves. As we all know that the month of Sha'ban has started, which keeps us less than a month away from now, from today to the month of Ramadan. And in a few weeks, the month of Ramadan will be starting, inshallah. We ask the Almighty Allah to remove this difficulty from the Ummah, and we are able to utilize the month of Ramadan in the best way possible. And we are able to connect ourselves spiritually with the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the masajid, inshaAllah. Today we are talking about the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is recorded in Imam Nasa'i's Sunan on the authority of Usama bin Zayd radiallahu anhu. And when he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fasting. Now fasting is considered to be one of the greatest amal in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zayd ibn Aslam radiallahu anhu mentions that al-a'malu khamsatun, actions are of five types. Number one, either you get the reward or compensation of it according to the action that you have performed. Number two are those that make something compulsory upon you. Number three types of actions are those that will give you the reward 10 times more than what you have performed. And the next one is that action, number four, are those actions that gives you the reward of 700 times more than what you have performed. And the last category of action are those that has no reward in the world, and Allah only knows what reward Allah can give on that action. And then Zayd ibn Aslam radiallahu anhu explains in regards to the action that has equal reward or compensation or wizr, the grasp of Allah or the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the action that a person, when he intends to do bad and he commits a bad action, Allah only gives him one sin for the action that he has done wrong. But if a person makes the intention to do a good deed, but he is not able to perform that good deed for some reason, Allah still gives him one reward. So making an intention of a good deed, and for some reason you're not able to do so, Allah still gives you the reward of performing that good deed. So inshallah, we can, as much as possible, we should try to make intentions of doing good actions, at least to the minimum that Allah is going to give us one reward for performing that one good action. The second type of actions are al-mujibat. The actions, in exchange of that, things become compulsory upon that. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من مات وهو لا يشرك بالله سبحانه وتعالى وجبت له الجنة أخرج البخاري في الصحيح. That whoever dies in a stage that he does not ascribe any partners with Allah, and he has done his actions sincerely for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, Jannah becomes obligatory upon this person. Allah makes Jannah wajib upon him. And then the narration carries on. This is the narration of Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu anhu, that when he said, Ya Mu'adh, لبيك وسعديك يا رسول الله. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Oh Mu'adh, that you know." And Mu'adh replied that I am present, O Prophet of Allah. And at that time, Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said that, "Oh Mu'adh, whoever dies in a stage that he has not ascribed any partners with Allah, Allah makes Jannah wajib for him. وَمَنْ مَاتَ وَهُوَ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ وَجَبَتْ لَهُ النَّارِ." And the person who dies in a stage that, you know, he has ascribed partners with Allah or he has not worshipped Allah solely, then Jahannam becomes wajib upon him. And we ask Allah to protect us from this. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So the second type of actions are those that makes the reward or the compensation of it compulsory upon that individual. So that is either dying in a stage of ikhlas or dying in a stage of shirk. And we ask Allah to protect ourselves from shirk. The third type of actions are those that when you do one good deed, Allah gives you reward in tenfold. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and Allah himself mentions in the Quran that man ja'a bil hasanati falahu ashru amthaliha, the one who performs or brings one good deed, we are going to give him reward equal to 10. So one hasana gives you the reward of 10. If you spend $1 for the sake of Allah, for the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah returns 10 in you. But then when you are spending money, the reward increases. That's the fourth category. Any action that you do, you get 10 reward, then Allah increases on top of that according to your sincerity and your intention. The fourth type of actions are those actions which gives you the reward of performing that action 700 times. So you only did one action, but Allah is going to give you reward multiplied by 700. Zayd ibn Aslam who mentions, and that is al-jihadu fi sabilillah wal-infaqu fi sabilillah. It's to strive for the benefit of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's to sacrifice for the sake of Allah's deen. Number one, each sacrifice that you give for the sake of Allah's deen, Allah is going to reward you 700 times more than your one sacrifice. Similarly, wal-infaqu fi sabilillah, the one who spends money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for good causes, for the house of Allah, for the masjid, for good resources, for the things that are connected with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, spending $1 or one dirham is going to give you reward 700 times. So you spend $1, Allah is going to give you reward $700, spending for $700. Imagine if you give $20, as we do our practice when we come to the house of Allah on the day of Jum'ah, those brothers and sisters and families that come to ICI to pray their Jum'ah, we encourage you to inshallah continue to give that $20 per week to help the expenses of the masjid. And this is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we will take care of the house of Allah, Allah is going to take care of our own homes. And the way you secure the house of Allah, Allah is going to secure you and your house, inshallah. So the one who gives money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the deen of Allah, in return Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him the reward of 700. And the fifth action, which the reward is not given in this world, the reward of which the world doesn't have the capacity of giving, and that is the reward of fasting. That the world, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, "As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bihi," that fasting is for me and I become the reward of fasting. And the world doesn't have the capacity to give that reward. Only Allah knows what type of reward Allah is going to give for those who fast. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was fasting in the month of Sha'ban, Usama bin Zayd radiyallahu anhu says, "Ya Rasulullah, أراك تصوم في شهر ما لم يرى في غير شهر أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام." That I see you fasting in this month, that I don't see you fasting as much in any other month. What was the regular practice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam when it come to practicing? Ibn Rajab mentions on the commentary of this hadith that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam would fast every Monday and Thursday of the week. And then in addition to that, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would fast 13th, 14th and 15th of every Islamic calendar or lunar calendar of the month. So 13, 14, 15, and then every week, Mondays and Thursdays. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would, in Aisha radiallahu anha mentions, he would fast so excessively that he would actually connect the month of Sha'ban, the month of Ramadan, in excessive fasting. So then Usama bin Zayd said, Ya Rasulullah, I see you fasting in this month that I don't see you fasting as much in the other month. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Dhaka shahrun. This is the month which is located between Ramadan and Rajab. And وَهُوَ يَغْفَلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ. Due to the significance of the month of Rajab and due to the significance of the month of Ramadan, people forget this month. Right? People forget this month. So, but this is the month in which the actions of the believers are presented in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأُحِبُّ أَنْ يَرْفَعَ عَمَلِي وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. I would like that when my actions are being presented in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am fasting. Why? Because fasting is the most beloved action in the sight of Allah. Allah Himself becomes the reward of that fasting. So, in the month of Sha'ban, we have to be very vigilant in our ibadat, in our worship. What can we do? Maximum fasting is one of the actions. And then inshallah, we are going to have a lecture via Zoom, and the link would be sent soon on the Facebook account, that, you know, about the significance of the month of Sha'ban and the significance of the 15th of Sha'ban, inshallah. So we ask Allah to grant us the understanding. We ask Allah to give us the ability to value this month. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from everyone, inshallah. We request, inshallah, everyone to make dua for yourself, for your family members, for the communities, for the community out there, for every individual who has been affected by this virus. And we ask Allah to remove this virus from the ummah. And we ask Allah to bring prosperity, and we ask Allah to bring rahmah and mercy, inshallah, to the entire globe. And we ask Allah to remove this difficulty from the ummah, you know, as quickly as possible, and grant everyone afiyah and protection. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'iril muslimin fastaghfiru innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من صلى وصام وصل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من قعد وقام وصل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والصحابة المقربين رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا واجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا وجعل الفردوس هي دارنا آمين يا رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين